Now let's meet today's starting lineups. First, for the visiting Principia Panthers. A 6-foot senior from Seat Pleasant, Maryland, number 0, Shamari Miles. And a 6'1 senior from Lauderdale Lakes, Florida, number 3, AJ Bird. And a 6'3 senior from Bethalto, Illinois, number 4, Jaquan Adams. And a 6'3 junior from Modesto, California, number 11, Isaiah Parker. And a 6'4 junior from Tehachapi, California, number 30, Charlie Hoffman. The Panthers are coached by Todd Zimmerman and assisted by Nico Dominguez. And now, let's meet today's starting lineups for your Eureka Red Devils! Introducing first, a 6'4 sophomore from Morton, Illinois, number 4, Ben Carter! And a 6-foot senior from Peoria, Illinois, number 5, Noah Persich! And a 6'2 junior from Peoria, Illinois, number 10, Pee Wee Brown. And a 6-foot junior from Rock Falls, Illinois, number 11, Jalen Johnson. And a 6-foot 10-inch senior from Peoria, Illinois, number 24, Cody Bayer. The Red Devils are coached by Chip Wilde and assisted by Jessica Thorman and Jake Boyd and managed by Zoe Wilde.
Kareem, it feels like a classic kind of matchup with the maroon and the gray uniforms. I don't know, it just gives me classic basketball vibes.
Yeah, almost the vibe of a playoff game. I was super excited during the national anthem and the lineup calling. I'm super excited for this game here.
Again, really good matchup, Jaquan Adams. Slack, leading scorer, the reigning player of the week. Cody Bear tipping it off against him. Eureka winning the tip. Jalen Johnson will bring it up the court.
Spencer, a quick thing to note before this game really gets started. Principia has never won a single game on Eureka's home floor, and I'm pretty sure they have noted that.
Principia, again, a really tough squad. Seventh place currently in the Slack. Jaquan Adams missed some time earlier on in the season, but full go tonight. Brown, tough take, can't finish. Rebound there for Shamari Miles. Again, this is another really balanced scoring side from Principia. We talked about in the women's game. Principia's men's side, also 4 guys in double-digit scoring.
Yes, I'm super excited for this game. That's Miles able to get on the board there. Yeah, they got 4 guys almost averaging 13+. Really well-balanced offensive attack.
It's kind of a mixed bag with Principia in terms of the results in the SLIAC. You know, some really close losses earlier on in the slate. A couple of big losses in the first bucket of the night.
Pee Brown, he loves that mid-range game.
Again, should be a fun matchup. We saw this team twice last year. We'll see him again once more in this season.
And the last matchup, a nail-biter OT win for the Red Devils.
Adams' first shot of the game is a miss. We talked about it pregame, whether or not it would be Pee Wee Brown, in fact, guarding Adams. At least on that possession, that was the case. Johnson can't knock that through.
And I'm hoping to see more of that.
Charlie Hoffman not starting a lot of games this season, but getting the start today. What do you think they see in the lineup?
Shooting. We know we've seen him knock down some big threes last game out. So, I just got totally confused. I'm sorry about that. You said Hoffman. I'm thinking, I don't know why I thought you said Hoff. That was totally on me.
No worries.
I mean, Loft.
Yeah, but, I mean, Jonah Loft, another guy we probably see. This is a good matchup for him size-wise, like you said. Brown, again, another bucket, 4 points already for him. He's gunning for that SLAC player of the week after a 39-point performance. Three-pointer left short there.
Bird with a lot of lift on his jump shot on that attempt.
That kind of reminds me of Carson Edwards.
Yeah.
Crazy bounce.
Name I haven't heard in a while.
Cross-court pass through the hands, ends up in Jalen Johnson's, and then kind of throws it out of bounds. That's another thing. Turnovers is always a main, you know, you want to win a game, you don't turn the ball over. And you hate to see a sloppy one like that.
Yeah, you just hate those. As we keep saying it, we sound like broken records. Unforced errors, unforced turnovers. That one a bit more forced.
Yeah, that pass certainly deflected originally. And just kind of a slower death on that possession. Good hands away from the ball. Again, Adams trying to work on Brown underneath. Brown, and a steal there.
This is what I love about Pee Wee Brown. We all know he can score the ball. His defensive tenaciousness and willing to take the defensive assignment.
Bear double team. Johnson underneath. Head fake. Gets to the right side. Misses the layup. Gets his own miss. Finds Carter. A little embellishment there. Carter misses the reverse. The Red Devils get nothing out of that.
Yeah, a bunch of good looks, but no results as Jalen Johnson ends up almost with the steal and he dribbles it out of bounds. Now we can tell he's a bit mad at himself. He missed that easy layup, then almost easy turnover right there.
Yeah, we talked like just bunnies, the ones that add up at the end of the game.
Yeah.
And you certainly would hate for this to be a game that goes into overtime and you had 2 points or right there at the rim.
Yeah. What I did like from Jalen Johnson, after the first miss, he didn't try to force a second shot.
Hoffman wasn't ready for it. Adams scrapping for it. Stuffed by Carter.
Carter says, not in his house. I know you're the leading scorer, but it's not going to come that easy.
Again, Jaquan Adams, a tough guy to phase. You might get one on him, but he's gonna get his, yeah, whether or not.
If you average 24 a game.
Strong guy, ducks his head, jump hook, rattles out. Johnson collects a rebound.
Early on, you can tell the Red Devils are keen in and focusing defensively on on Adams.
Brown lost it for a moment. Bear picked up by Hoffman. Bear kicks out. Persich able to save it, spikes it. It's like a game of spike ball there. Carter over Adams, left short.
Put enough on it.
Adams, again, good defensive player as well. A lot of length. And they're going to blocking foul there on Johnson.
Adams with a little low sweep through.
6 points between the two teams in the first 4 minutes of action. So Bobby Alford III checking onto the floor. He's their second leading scorer. Sort of a Lou Williams type situation.
Yeah.
A lot of points coming up off the bench. Floater up and in there, Isaiah Parker. Retied at 4, 15:40 to go in the first half. It's Pee Wee Brown held behind by Miles.
Another basketball fashion statement we're seeing right now. A bunch of the Principian guys, including Adams, are wearing the thick headband that we've seen guys like Shea Gilgeous-Alexander staple in the NBA. It's becoming a fashion trend.
Yeah, I certainly would like to play like Shea. You know, a lot of guys would. Can do it all. 11 seconds on the shot clock for Ben Carter and Jalen Johnson. It's Brown. Head fake. Looking to get around Parker. Trying to shake him. Tough three-pointer up. Knocked in from Pee Wee Brown.
Great move there by Pee Wee Brown.
He's got all of Eureka's points tonight.
Pee Wee Brown picking up where he left off against Greenville.
He's trying to show those 39 weren't because of inflation. Adams trying to bang his way down there. Parker open look from the corner. Knocked in to respond.
I know Pee Wee Brown, he's a good defender, but Adam does have him in the size department.
Parker had to let the bench know afterwards, too.
I ain't nothing wrong with that.
Nah, you know the bench is always chirping.
Yeah.
Especially when it's right in front of you. Pass gets saved, ends up back into the hands of Eureka. They don't get a reset, though. 10 seconds, down to 9. Brown, once again, Parker trying to stay in front, takes that one away from him. 2-on-2 break. Parker gets it knocked out from behind by Brown, saves it off the face.
And look at Pee Wee Brown making plays. He got the ball took from him, but he stayed at it defensively, got back, threw the ball off of Parker. Red Devils ball.
Tough guy to handle, Pee Wee Brown, offensively and defensively.
He's never going to back down.
Dylan Logsdon getting ready to check in at the next dead ball. Johnson to Carter. Principia done a good job of limiting Cody Bear's touches so far tonight. Here's Ben Carter, the jump hook.
I haven't even noticed. Cody Bear has he touched the ball offensively at all?
Maybe a couple of times. I think they forced him to pass. He's been double-teamed. Miles, tough take around Johnson.
That was a great, almost Michael Jordan-esque move. Fake like he was going back out then. Drove back baseline.
Johnson down low. Here's Bear. Jump hook from him. Knocked in. Only a matter of time. It's kind of like Thanos. He's inevitable.
Yep. Heard the noise.
Timeout taken by Coach Wilde with 13:42 remaining in the first half. 9-9. Low scoring affair here in Eureka right here on ECTV.
I thought you were driving.
I thought you were driving.
Oh, I never said I was driving.
I definitely can't drive. Okay.
If you're high, just don't drive. It's illegal everywhere. If you feel different, you drive different.
Welcome back to Eureka, Illinois. It's a tie game at 9 between two SLAC opponents in Principia and Eureka.
So far, Spence is... Seems like we have ourselves a good ball game tonight.
It's always the hope. Always want it to be a competitive game. Pee Wee Brown gets his first break with Dylan Logsdon on. Blake Logsdon looming. Adams to Miles, trying to get around Johnson. Lost his footing. Blake Logsdon on for Jalen Johnson. Going to draw a substitution, couple substitutions. It's Jordan Williams, as well as, it's like Kingsley Cockburn.
Jordan Williams and Bobby Alford III, high school teammates, both attending Christian Brothers High School. That's interesting.
Yeah, it's got to be nice to have some familiarity with your teammate.
Always.
Logs into Carter. Now Bear. Little jab step from Carter. Knocked in from 3.
Ben Carter airballed his first 3. Didn't waver his confidence, and he steps in and knocks down the second one to give the Red Devils a 3-point lead.
We've seen Ben Carter not being shy to shoot from the parking lot if need be.
And I love it.
Here's Williams. Trapped at the elbow. Miles able to keep it on their side of half court. 11 on the shot clock. Working on the sophomore, Logsdon. Kicks, Cockburn from 3, short. Blake Logsdon collects.
You see Principia, they have some shifty guards on their team.
It's going to be a lot of guard play tonight. Already seeing a lot from Shamari. Miles, now Bear. The shoulder bump. Both Logsdons went for that rebound, neither came up with it.
Yeah, Shamari Miles, man. Extremely aggressive offensively this game.
Yeah, you can tell that he's been given the green light to go get a bucket.
And we mentioned it, you know, Principia with those 4 guys, almost 13-plus. You never know who's going to be that second guy, even first guy some nights. Miles rises up and try to attempt some mid-range 3. I mean, jump shot.
You can tell he's trying to shoot off the glass on that, but kind of a missed angle there. Has a chronic just... I would just obliterate the side of backboards anytime I was in the corner, so I feel his pain. Logsdon from 3, yes! Eureka up 6.
Blake Logsdon stepping into the 3.
Yeah, a couple of 3-pointers in a row now for the Red Devils offensively. Williams trying to lose Persich. Good mid-range, can't knock it in, though. Carter knocked it off the leg of Williams.
That's the third time we've seen that this game.
It's the hustle plays that add up as well.
Yeah, Williams on that crossover move kind of used his size to force Blake Logsdon one way as he attempted his jump shot.
Kareem, do you think there's a way that you could incorporate that as a statistic, as like a save or forcing the ball to go back to you?
Oh, absolutely, because it's not hard to, you know, track it. You see a guy throw the ball off of someone else. As Ben Carter goes up for the slam. Got me lost for words for a second.
Just had to check with everything to make sure that was what just happened.
Oh, man, he just got up with ease.
That, Eureka loves that play where they can get Cody Bear to dump off that pass to Ben Carter.
Yeah. I mean, we've seen different variations of that pass from alley-oops to, as we just seen, a backdoor bounce pass right there.
Persich and Carter coming off for Coker and Brown. Eureka up 8. Principio with 18 on the shot clock now. Jaquan Adams trying to lose Andrew Coker. Tough take and good finish.
Andrew Coker, first minutes in this game. He had a great game versus Greenville last game out, ending with 10 points.
Adams' first points of the night. I think you're going to be happy if you're Eureka and limiting 9.5 minutes of score-free basketball from him.
Especially with a team where
Bear gets triple-teamed in the post. Cockburn comes up with a steal.
Definitely. I think I heard a smack from way up here.
Williams over to Bird. A two-man game being played. Williams. Tough take over Brown. Can't knock it in. And Brown dribbled on the baseline there.
And just Williams, I can tell he's one of those guys, you know, with some size, some muscle on him, but it doesn't deplete from his ball handling. And those can be scary guys to guard sometimes.
A guy like Jalen Brunson, the strength of a smaller guard. Something you have to be wary of. Adams, floater from the free throw line, knocked it. And he can score from, he doesn't like shooting threes, but willing to pop a floater from way out.
Yeah.
Coker shaking Adams, step back, three up, no good. Ooh. About added a really nice highlight to the mixtape.
Andrew Coker, that was a great move.
Eureka lead sitting at 4, Jaquan Adams trying to get one back and flung it over the backboard, late call there. And Adams a little shaken up.
Yeah.
What did you think, Kareem? A little bit of a late call, I thought.
Absolutely, it was a late call. I thought they were saying the ball was out of bounds until I seen the hand signals by the ref there. And we seen that deep floater from Adams, and a lot of times guys who aren't great jump shooters, we see them replace the jump shot with a floater and they expand their range on it. We seen that from guys like John Morant, Derrick Rose, who implement that deep floater, and Adam.
Shooter's touch there.
See the crowd letting him have it.
Crowd erupted for some reason. I don't know what it was about.
I have absolutely no idea.
Maybe he said something, maybe? I don't know. We saw him mixing it up a little bit with the crowd before the game, so nothing wrong with being a little bit of an entertainer.
And, you know, Pee Wee Brown, he gets the same treatment at during away games.
Oh, yeah. Brown to Coker. Coker right by Adams of the bucket, misses the layup. I think that's Coker that almost came up with that, too, but Miles just stopped in his track there by Pee Wee Brown. Cockburn trying to work on Coker, kicks Bird. Bird to the bucket over Logsdon. Great finish there.
This Principia team, they have some strong athletic guards on their team, guys who can create off the dribble and finish over the top of their defenders. It's definitely going to be a challenge to keep these guys out of the lane.
It's interesting, they've got Shamari Miles on Pee Wee Brown when the Red Devils are on offense, but then the Red Devils will combat Adams seemingly with mostly Brown. They're mixing in Coker as well.
Yeah. It's always interesting to see guys not necessarily match up on both sides of the floor.
Bird gonna dance with Dylan Logsdon. Adams right to the cup, lays it in with the right.
Adams, he loves when he drives to the lane to either put the ball up or down so you can't really swipe it away and kind of, you know, stretch out to the basket.
And he mixes up that tendency well enough that you can't cheat that, whether it's going to be up or down.
Yeah.
Brown, really tough take, can't finish. DeJesus has it knocked out of his hands. Ray Banzamuna onto the court for the first time. Some intel before the game telling me that high chance we see a lot of Ray Banzamuna tonight.
I'm very, very interested in, you know, what the coach is looking to do with him. We didn't see him at all in that Greenville game, but, you know, he's a guy who can get some buckets. You know, he's a three-point shooter, and, you know, his handle was kind of underrated.
Blake logs in from three. That time no good. Tipped out, though, to Brown. Brown will try a three. Also too strong and high-pointed well by Bird. Kareem, it looked like a 2-3 zone on that possession.
Yeah. Wonder if we're going to see some more of that.
Adams sizing up Banzamuna, trying to get to his left, and stuffed there by Banzamuna. They're saying it's off of Adams.
Red Devils seem to be in their own type of zone. When Adams just attacked to the basket, you know, he seen three or four maroon jerseys.
Adams was a pretty, not necessarily he wasn't heated, but the official certainly upset with what Adams was telling him. Anyway, 17-17, with 7:38 left in the first half of action. Break for them, break for us on ECTV.
I surrender, I surrender.
All right, pal. Get ready for the day, buddy.
Hey, Dad. Hey, Dad. We have a gun.
What's that?
We have a gun.
Just like that, the last break, tied up at 7, well, not at 17. There's been scoring since then, but in the sense it's tied still. 7:34 remaining in the first half. Brown tries a jump pass, didn't work. Principia, the quick steal. Slowed things down offensively. Quan Adams getting a screen. Floater off of one. An interesting thing here, Kareem. I think Jaquan Adams is shooting in from the field with his right hand, but he shoots free throws left-handed.
Yeah, you know, maybe that's kind of correlates to why he isn't as great of a jump shooter, hasn't really figured out which is his jump shooting hand.
Adams looking to back down Miles, spinning to his left. Tough take, bucket.
Moved there by Pee Wee Brown, a guy who on paper might not look like a strong guy, but he can have what they call it, wiry strength.
He's a tough dude, especially down low. He does not mind a post up at all. Miles to Bird. Bird, quick three. And Banzamuna with a rebound. Been kind of stale offensively from both teams. We were expecting a little bit more of a shootout with all the scoring potential on the floor, but perhaps the second half will be the other way, or maybe it's just a testament to both defenses.
Yeah, but more of a defensive game.
To Logs in deep, three up from him. That one no good. Adams with a rebound. Adams more than comfortable carrying the ball in that as well. Strong dribble straight to the bucket. Charge drawn there by Blake Logsden. Also inevitable.
I was going to say, it isn't a Eureka basketball game if we don't see at least one Logsden draw charge.
DeJesus coming off the floor for Bear.
I wonder, is it something like the Logsdens learned in high school, or these guys are just so good at drawing charges? Jalen Johnson as well.
And you got to make a living somehow. It's a good way to help out, especially help side, just understanding where you got to beat. They do it well. Kicked corner three, Coker. Bear with a rebound over Hoffman. Jump hook and a foul called. Two shots upcoming for Cody Bear. A replay here. So Logs in charge. Yeah, just sets his feet, and it helps that Adams is so strong. He just blows through him.
Yeah, I was going to say, you know, they've definitely done their homework. They've watched film of how aggressive Adams is and how he likes to drive the lane, and they just slide over and take that charge call.
Persich and Carter on for Banzmuna and Coker. 5:31 remaining.
Very interesting first half. You know, it started off a little high pace. Now it's kind of slowed down to more of a defensive game.
Five and a half minutes to go in the first half. Jaquan Adams fairly quiet so far. 6 points of his team's 17. Persich playing him to go left. Hoffman with Miles. 10 on the shot clock. Bird wants it. 5. Needs to get a shot up. Lost it on the way up. Knocked out of bounds by Blake Logsdon.
I think Bird was looking for more of a foul on that play. Not really looking to score. And this team going to try to advance the ball. Score the ball 1 second.
Shot clock violation. Parker needed to be the one to take that shot with one left.
I was going
to
say, I don't think Parker knew a time left.
Nothing wrong with being unselfish. Unless there's 1 second left on the shot clock, then you need to be a little bit selfish. Just fling one at the rim if you have to. Under 5, 4-point game. The Red Devils looking to defend their home court where they've been above 500, playing in front of the home fans. It's been their road games. They've had some struggles. Carter kicks out. Bear, jab step, 3 from the big man. Spins out. Hoffman, we're saying it's off of Brown. I think it's a bit of a makeup call there. I think Brown might have been about called for a foul, but they elected to just say it went off of him on that, which we should probably relay to him instead of him being mad.
we'll just take the out-of-bounds call.
I would certainly take that. Brown, no fouls yet, which is massive as we close in on halftime. Miles tried to find Hoffman, and almost out-of-bounds. Good finish from Hoffman on the baseline.
Does that still count as an assist?
I think so. The double bounce pass.
One of our players kind of tipped it off as Pee-wee Brown gets the turnover. Picks it back up.
Persich, a lot of time at the three-point line. Yes! A welcome sign. Noah Persich knocking down a 3.
Much needed. We've had 3 or 4 big threes in this game already to keep that lead.
Yeah, Blake Logsdon, Noah Persich, Ben Carter, all with 3s. As well as Pee-wee Brown. We kind of expect him to hit 1 at some point. Shoots a lot. Tough take. Miles can't finish. Hoffman fighting for it. Ends up with it. Nobody guarding him. Lowers the shoulder on Carter, and they get a hand, believe on, hand of the cookie jar on Pee-wee Brown.
Yeah, I think Pee-wee Brown was a little sleek defensively at first, trying to find Miles, and he didn't see the man cutting, and last second tried to bail himself out and ended with a foul.
It's a tough break.
Yeah.
You expect somebody to be guarding the guy cutting towards the basket, and then, wait a minute,
you
I have something
around
to do.
Yeah.
Parker back on. Hoffman will come off the floor at the next dead ball.
This is the second team in a row. Greenville also, we've seen 4 or 5 guys on the team from the state of California.
Yeah, I don't know what kind of recruiting is being done here, but all of our guys are outside of the Logsdons are from Illinois.
Yeah.
And even they have ties to around this area, at least.
Yeah.
Brother Bryce, who they faced off against up at Aurora. Bryce on the coaching staff. Backdoor cut, read well there by Miles. Adams in transition, traveled, and goes down holding his knee. Again, we've seen people slip and fall the last few games. He's able to get up.
I will say this, though. I've seen the floor being mopped and swept ahead of this game.
Gets called for a travel on that. Definitely frustrated with both the aspect of slipping, getting called for a turnover, and tweaking your knees, never fun.
We got a towel boy out here.
Doing excellent work over there.
In the Crocs. Yeah, he definitely slipped. Oh.
Brown kind of tweaked his ankle on the back end of that, too.
Oh, that's the worst when you slip and, like, extend your knee.
Yeah, those non-contact ones, especially you see it a lot in like football with those guys trying to change direction or they get hit, and yeah, that leg locks up. Fortunately, still out there, not willing to come out of the game. He knows he's about 3 minutes from halftime. If he needs to take a look at it, he can. It's a four-point game. Bear looking to spin and travel before he got started.
I thought they let him get away with it, but they seen it.
.253 left. Principia having some struggles offensively, Kareem.
Yeah, I was going to say Red Devils have been doing a good job of maintaining not only Adams, but Miles Rail and the rest of this Principia team, who we know has a bunch of scores.
Miles, too strong. Persich gets a rebound. It's another thing, the Eureka rebounding, they've done a great job of limiting second chances for this Principia side. Carter from way outside, nope. Old volleyball act there by Cody Bear, just tipping it out from everybody.
Man, that's the top of this.
Brown guarded by Miles. One-handed the pass. Carter will just take it over and back. Good hustle there. You'd hate to see Adams get a free run out.
Yeah.
Really put some energy into their bench.
Probably was 2 points, might even end it in a dunk. We seen Cody Bear, you know, tip that ball out. That's something I seen a guy like Paul Gasol not only do, but I watched an interview of him talking about, you know, how he learned how to tip the ball out and tip it to his teammates instead of just trying to come down with the rebound, which is something that can be extremely valuable for a big.
Did he give any reasoning for why?
I forgot the exact reason. This was 2015 when he was on the Bulls when he was talking about it, so almost 10 years ago. But as a kid, I was very fascinated by it.
Six on the shot clock. Williams over Brown. Still, again, it seems like another instance of first half cement on the rim.
Yeah.
For both these teams, we saw it in the women's game as well. Brown all the way to the bucket. Nice finish.
Pee Wee Brown slithering around a defender.
11 for Pee Wee Brown, leading all scorers. Principia taking their time. Adams trying to lose Persich. Jump hook looked like the Jordan logo for a second.
Yeah.
Both legs splayed out there.
And the Red Devils, they're not letting Adams get anything off. Every time he goes one-on-one, they send the help side defender. Ben Carter shoots a three over the backboard.
Miles check in for Williams. Yeah, I think maybe Principia was thinking, just looking at the heights of these guys and weren't thinking about the strength. Oh, no, Persich, again, not the tallest guy out there, but he's built well. He doesn't give up a lot of ground. Brown doesn't give up a lot of ground. It's been a lot of those matchups. They've been trying to switch either Brown or Persich onto Adams. And they're just straight up giving Persich Adams right now.
Yeah.
There's Bird into the corner trying to find Adams in the post. Double team behind the back. Adams over Persich. Blocking foul that time. That one looked more set than any of them.
Yeah, it definitely did. He anticipated that. And watching this game, you can tell the Red Devils have watched a lot of film on Adams. We've seen Blake Lawson get the charge on him earlier. And then the double teams, we see them. They know where he's going to be positioned on that. On that play, they hit him on the pick and pop, but they knew Adams isn't a shooter. He wasn't going to take the jump shot. And unfortunately, they didn't get the charge call on that attempt.
I could have sworn that Noah Persich jump stopped to get into position on that.
Yeah.
Maybe not. Official saw something different. Maybe he leaned a little bit more. We can't really. That's a hard angle to read body movement from this spot. But Adams, I mean, really doing a lot of the damage at the free throw line.
Yeah.
You can call it damage. He's been pretty quiet.
Not really able to put his stamp on this game yet. No Red Devils. Give them all credit defensively.
Good chance for the Red Devils to go about a pretty natural 2-for-1 here. Plenty of time. And Johnson instead travels.
I looked away for 1 second.
It's a replay on that blocking foul from earlier. Pretty set to me.
Yeah.
Maybe just he caught him on the one side of his body.
I was thinking that he didn't get full body, kind of angled sideways.
It's a tough thing. Adams can certainly move around in the air pretty well. Nice kick out. Miles, three, way off.
And the Red Devils, again, another good defensive stop.
They have the last shot if they want it.
Shot clock is off. I think they definitely go hold for the last shot.
They're going to give Pee Wee Brown.
Pee Wee stepping extremely close to that half court line.
Just making sure the officials are paying attention. Brown, the pick and roll. Miles pokes it loose. 2 seconds left. Miles gets blocked there at the end of the half by Brown. Kind of just sums up how that first half went. Just kind of sloppy. Can't really get a whole lot of momentum going.
All defense in that half. And, you know, I've been harping on it, but great job defensively by the Red Devils of maintaining not only Adams, but Miles and the team as a whole. You, as I mentioned, you could tell they watched a lot of film and studied a lot of film defensively, at least.
It's a four-point game in favor of the Red Devils here at halftime. After a short break, we'll be back with the halftime programming honoring the 1993-1994 national champions. So they're back in town. Look forward to bringing that one to you. But Red Devils leading 26-22 here at halftime.
When it comes to making plans, you are the best. What about those barbecues you plan in detail for your family? Or your daughter's first costume party? It was out of this world. The same way you plan each detail for those moments, start planning to protect you and your loved ones from a natural disaster. Sign up for local weather and emergency alerts. Prepare an emergency kit and make a family communications plan. Protecting your family is the best plan you can make.
Calvin got diagnosed June 10th of 2018. He has Rhabdomyosarcoma sarcoma, a soft tissue cancer. But St. Jude has covered everything. And coming here, they're like, we are going to do everything we can. And when they say everything, they mean everything. St. Jude is like the gold at the end of a rainbow for a family like ours. They've really given our family hope. And we are so grateful and thankful for everything.
And welcome back inside the Christine Bonatti Bullwinkle Arena. The 93-94 national champs making their way to the floor. We prepare to get things started here and kind of their ceremony of honor. Obviously a pretty shining moment. The history of Eureka College's basketball, one of the more successful teams in school history of any sport. And it's great to have them all along with us, especially back in person. We're going to send it down to the table, Ethan Hedge.
At this time, we welcome the 1994 National Championship team back to the Christine Bonatti Bullwinkle Arena. Give them a hand, folks.
Rounds it. 5 seconds left. Wolves trail it by three.
Been very successful at scoring. Out of bounds.
Chad Buckelhide for three. Can't hit it. And the rebound is Schmidt again. That's going to do it. The Eureka Red Devils, the NAIA Division II national champions. Dave Darnell and his...
Led by legendary coach Dave Darnell in his final season at Eureka, the 1993-94 men's basketball team achieved unparalleled success on their way to winning a national title. This record-breaking team boasted an impressive 27-4 record and maintained a spotless 12-0 record at home inside of the old Reagan Center. The Red Devils took down defending national champion Willamette in the Elite Eight and Final Four host Northwest Nazarene in the semifinals to advance to the championship game. The much-anticipated final proved to be a storybook ending to a historic season as the Red Devils defeated Northern State out of South Dakota 98-95 in overtime. The individual accolades were just as impressive as the team's collective success. Coach Dave Darnell was rightfully honored as the NAIA Division II National Coach of the Year. Senior Troy Tyler became the school's all-time leading scorer, putting up 610 points that season and 2,119 throughout his career. Senior Chris Eaton emerged as the school's all-time leading rebounder, pulling down 363 boards that season and 925 throughout his career. Eaton was later named National Player of the Year. And senior Chris Peterson was selected as the national tournament's MVP, scoring 36 points in the championship game, including a game-winning free throw in overtime. Please step forward as your name is called so that we can recognize each and every one of you for your contributions toward the 1994 title. First, Randy Begold, the student assistant coach, trainer, and a part of the team Hall of Fame.
Not across that guy's right.
Carl Carlson, an administrative assistant and a part of the team Hall of Fame.
No.
Chris Carter, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Dave Darnell, the head coach and a part of our Hall of Fame and the NAIA National Championship Coach of the Year. Chris Eaton, a part of our Hall of Fame, the NAIA Player of the Year and Eureka College's all-time leading rebounder. Doug Hatterman, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Chris Hopwood, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Dennis Huttenlocker, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Dale Coleman, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Ryan Markley, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Chris Peterson, a part of our team Hall of Fame and the NAIA National Tournament MVP. Stan Prosser, one of the assistant coaches and a part of the Hall of Fame. Dwayne Schmedik, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Troy Tyler, a part of our Hall of Fame, the NAIA All-American and Eureka College's all-time leading scorer. Jeff Tyler, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Peter Vaughn, a part of our team Hall of Fame. Chuck Wirtz, an assistant coach and a part of our team Hall of Fame as well. We also would like to honor those who could not be here today, Shane Brown, the trainer and a part of the Team Hall of Fame. Greg Kreider, a part of our Team Hall of Fame. And the late coach, Dennis Dighton, an assistant coach and part of our Team Hall of Fame as well. To achieve success of this magnitude, it takes a village of people surrounding the program who are supportive and do everything that they can to aid us in our success. We want to thank everyone who supported our 1994 team and their We want to thank everyone who supported our 1994 team and their historic national championship run. On this day and every day, we are thankful for those who support the success of our student athletes in the classroom and on the playing field. And at this time, we ask Coach Dave Darnall if he would like to share some words.
First of all, I'd like to thank Coach Weldy, Development Department, the Athletic Department, for making this afternoon possible. It's hard to believe it's been 30 years since this outstanding accomplishment occurred. And it was once in a lifetime. I thank Bonnie, my family, the parents of my players, the fans, the students for their support of me and my teams. During the 1994 season, the players played in front of a full house. A special thanks to Dan Herod, a great supporter of the team, for getting me on the planes to Idaho since I don't want to fly. I also want to thank all of you who purchased chairs or made donations in other areas of this arena. Without your help, this beautiful place would not be possible. Thanks to Dr. Sanders for his donations to get the Darnell floor done. We all miss our great assistant coach, Dennis Dighton, and other former players who are no longer with us, including Lance Kraft and Kevin Brown, who played with these guys. I'm sorry that Coach LaCurcia, Coach Sutzer, Coach Schweitzer were not able to come today. Three ladies that I really adore. This team will go down in history as one of the best NAI two basketball teams ever. Only team in the tournament that did not give athletic scholarships, beat the top three 1993 teams, the smallest enrollment in entered, the alma mater of President Ronald Reagan. This team gave its retiring coach the best farewell gift ever, a national championship. My book, Road to Destiny, TWW, has a great story of this championship journey. We wish our current teams good luck this year, and I'm sorry about what has been happening here. Thank you for coming. Thank you, Eureka College Water Crew, for the good job they did last night in making this day possible. Together we win.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, the 1994 National Championship team.
And a great send-off for the 1993-1994 team celebrating their 30th year after the championship. Again, national champions. Thank you to them. On the other side of this break, we'll have more recap from the first half and second half action between Principia and Eureka on ECTV.
When people ask us who we are, we tell them we're problem solvers, opportunity creators, community builders, and change makers. We are Rotary. Around the world, our network of 1.4 million neighbors, friends, and leaders volunteer their skills, expertise, and resources to solve issues and address community needs. We are people of action. Join us, and together, we can make an even greater impact. Find out how you can get involved at rotary.org/action.
Proportion to me is the lived experience of our Division III student athletes. They balance life from an academic perspective and the rigors of competing at a high level, bonding with teammates and building lifelong friendships. But they also are involved in their communities. They work jobs and internships and volunteer. They've learned to be resilient. Diverse experiences are setting them up for the future.
Passion's love. Passion is love for what you do. Because I think when you face challenges, it comes down to how much you want it and how much you love it. Passion is what keeps you going forward. Seeing so many people that were like-minded and so hardworking in their sport and academics, being surrounded by like-minded people makes you want to be more passionate. I think it pushes you to a different level that maybe you didn't think you had. And you can do the best of both worlds and love all of it.
A good citizen is someone who wants to make a positive impact, both in their communities and in the world around them. The Division III approach is absolutely the best approach out there for amateur sport because it wants student athletes to explore all parts of who they are. Be successful in the classroom, be successful in competition, be successful in the community. So our student athletes learn what it means to strive for and attain success, but doing it the right way and being good citizens.
Comprehensive learning is being able to adapt to experiences and apply the things that I learned. being an athlete and juggling academics helped me grow as a person, and things that I've learned, I was able to apply it in another field, putting them into everyday life. Developing comprehensive learning helped me prioritize certain things to make sure I get to where I want to be.
Responsibility is being accountable for your words and actions, first and foremost. It also is an obligation to be a positive influence in the communities around you. Being in a D3 program, you're going to have lots of different opportunities. You're not just an athlete, you're also involved in student life. Your academics are extremely important. We give a lot of our student athletes responsibilities right from the start by giving them leadership opportunities, by having them engage in the community, be a positive influence. That's being a responsible person.
I believe sportsmanship is a mutual admiration and respect for your fellow competitors. We all go through a lot to reach the point where we compete against one another. It's important to realize that. So once we're finally on the field or on the court or on the starting block, we look at each other as fellow human beings and not just competitors. Being able to recognize the hard work that other athletes are putting in creates a more positive and inclusive environment.
Being a part of the different activities and organizations that I've been a part of, I'm actually able to see myself where I'm like, hey, I actually can make a change. I'm one person that can make a difference.
Division III has helped me to develop teamwork skills, critical thinking skills, time management skills.
It's not just about basketball or it's not just about school. It's about developing yourself as a person altogether.
I think I finally found. Hey, how you doing?
Hey, Mason.
Hey, Mason.
Got a new house. It's looking pretty cool so far. I'm teaching Louise how to cook some lasagna. Thank you.
Study, please.
I think I finally found a place to make my own. A place that I call home. This place that I call home.
When I never graduated from high school, I realized I wanted to go back to school because I didn't want to work these backbreaking jobs the rest of my life. With the help of my father and having my son, that was all the motivation that I needed to come back to school. I felt accomplished. It made me feel that I could take on whatever challenges life throws at you.
Find free adult education classes near you at finishyourdiploma.org.
Si necesitas hacer algo para sentirte bien para manejar, mejor no manejes.
Women are bad with money. That's what the world's been saying for centuries. But now, we've got something to say.
Save it.
It's time to save ourselves
by saving our money.
Until we're no longer 80% more likely than men to live in poverty in retirement.
Save it. The falsehoods, the feelings of fault.
Then, the funds. Learn how to save for your retirement at wesaysaveit.org.
When people ask us who we are, we tell them we're problem solvers, opportunity creators, community builders, and change makers. We are Rotary. Around the world, our network of 1.4 million neighbors, friends, and leaders volunteer their skills, expertise, and resources to solve issues and address community needs. We are people of action. Join us, and together, we can make an even greater impact. Find out how you can get involved at rotary.org/action.
Welcome back to Eureka, Illinois. Post-festivities, 26-22 as play gets prepared to restart. Eureka leading. And it is Pee Wee Brown leading the way scoring-wise. 11 points, 5 rebounds from him. Kareem, anything else that jumps out to you from that first half?
Yeah, Spencer, I do have some statistics here to talk that I want to talk about. The trio combination of Adams, Miles, and Bird are combined 6 for 18, 33%. And if you guys don't know, this trio averages almost 50 points a game of Principia 70, and they're all top 15 in scoring in the SLIAC conference. So to hold these guys to 33% in a halftime, great defense by Eureka. I can't stress it enough.
Also, Bobby Alford, no points in that first half. He comes into this one averaging nearly 14 points per game. So again, a real testament to the Eureka defense today. Play again restarted. Shamari Miles in possession to Parker. Trying to get around Carter. Nice look. No look pass, excuse me. Bird lost it on the way up. Bird having to dance with Carter. Three-pointer up, tough shot, no good. That's just been kind of what Eureka's been doing, is forcing a lot of tough shots.
They've been in all the spaces on layups, jump shot attempts, whatever. They're just taking all the space away.
Ben Carter, mid-range jump shot knocked in.
And that there again is a variation of that play, you know, that little, I don't even know what to call it when they give the ball to Cody Bear and Ben Carter dives right there. We see him shoot the jump shot instead of like a lob or anything like that.
Miles, nice shot there over Johnson.
Miles trying to get himself going in this second half. He was 2 for 6 in the first half.
I think the pace of play has already picked up since the first half. Brown, tough readjustment. Persich to follow. That's what Noah Persich does for you, just fills in the cracks.
He'll clean it up for you. He's definitely a Swiss Army knife type of fella.
6-point lead for the Red Devils. Minute and a half into the second half. Red Devils looking to make up some ground in the SLIAC today.
Yeah.
Principia up a couple of spots on him in the standings. I like that play from Pee Wee Brown. A lot of times we've seen him go a little too fast in games prior.
Yeah, and that's the third turnover there by Adams. The fifth turnover combined for that trio of Adams, Miles, and Bird.
Red Devils running their set here. Bear, Persich. Bird, good defense on Persich. Bear down low, quick shot over Hoffman. Nice take.
And all else fails, find Cody Bear.
That's a tough shot to make. You're what, 12 feet from the basket on a jump hook? He didn't know where the basket was when he turned around for it. Jaquan Adams. Parker trying to get around Carter. Hoffman now working on Bear. Good touch there.
Hoffman coming right back at Bear.
6-point lead for the Red Devils. Again, looking to snap. Bit of a cold spell. They've only won one of their last 9, I believe.
Taylor Johnson, he rises up and he misses the 3.
Miles, 100 miles an hour the other way. Hoffman behind the arc. Rattles out. Adams scrapping for a rebound.
A lot of contact on that rebound.
Parker from 3. No, Bird with another chance. Bird swung it to the corner, and I think he thought that Kingsley Cockburn was in the field of play.
I never seen that in person. That's why sometimes being an active teammate on the bench, come back to bite you.
They're saying it went off of Eureka. Didn't see that one, Kareem.
I did not as well. I thought Parker completely threw that ball away.
See if the ball lies. Adams, elbow, kicks, Miles, 3, up. Looks like the ball was on our side.
Indeed does not lie.
It's been a lot of Principia's looks today. They're not awful looks. It's just sometimes it's just not going in. Obviously, Eureka's defense has been sensational near the basket. Pee Wee Brown just not being stopped near said basket.
second time we've seen Pee Wee Brown just get easy money on that post up with Miles guarding him.
And Miles, no slouch defensively.
Yeah.
Brown just better offense right now. Adams kicks corner. Hoffman tries his hand again. That one no good as well.
See, the difference is on Brown's post up, they're only soft doubling. On Adams' post up, they're hard doubling.
And couldn't finish that off, but mercy, what a move. Three guys coming in from Principia. Williams, Alford, as well as Cockburn. It's an 8-point Eureka lead. Again, they're 4-3 at home this season, but on the road, no such luck. Still looking for their first road win. Task at hand, though. Get a win in front of the home crowd. Miles still not able to knock down a three. I don't know if he has not hit one yet.
And Miles, I believe he's 3-for-8 on the night now. Ben Carter with the grown man move.
Full timeout taken by Principia. It's a 10-point lead for the Red Devils. 9 points from Ben Carter. The Red Devils looking to throw on the cruise control soon here on ECTV.
Eva Marie smoked 12,000 packs of cigarettes over 15 years. She quit, and now there's a new lung cancer screening that could save her life. You stopped smoking, now start screening. No matter how much you smoked, early detection could save you. Talk to your doctor or learn more at savedbythescan.org.
10-point lead for the Red Devils. They look to get a home win in front of the 30th anniversary of the 1993-1994 national champs. Pee Wee Brown leading the way with 13 points, followed closely by Ben Carter with 9. Kareem, Eureka's defense has been their calling card today.
Their defense has been amazing. In these first almost 5 minutes of play, they've held Principia to only 4-point score coming out of halftime. And in the first half, they held Principia to 9 of 26 shooting as a team. You got to give all credit to defense.
Cockburn will be the one to get it across half court. Principia again looking for any sort of momentum. Eureka's going to try to throw things around. The 2-3 zone for the Red Devils.
And the zone has been definitely helping. We've been seeing a lot of help side defense.
Splashed home there from Parker. That's his second one.
Parker, the lefty.
8 points from him tonight.
Left-hand shooters have the nicest looking jump shots.
That's really unfair. It's kind of like left-handed hitters in baseball. Just, it looks better.
It does.
Johnson going to try to respond. Unable to do so. Bear scrapping for a rebound. Trapping the corner. And they do get a foul there on Alford.
Yeah, I was going to say he's definitely a lot of contact. But I would say the refs have been letting, you know, a lot of contact slide in this game as a whole on both sides. The calls have been kind of even. I can't complain, really.
Yeah, there's only been 9 calls or 9 fouls called in this game so far. Brown trying to shake the ball around to keep it away from everybody. Persich will reset. Principia running a zone of their own. Ben Carter makes him pay.
Ben Carter, that's his second 3-pointer of the night.
And that's the danger with running a 2-3 zone is you leave a lot of open looks for 3-point shooters with the right ball movement. Eureka back in their man-to-man. Going to drive, kick out. 3-pointer up. Williams this time way too strong. And Carter will bring it up himself. We get right past Adams. Dream shake, lost Adams' footing. Bear brings it down. Bear gets fouled from behind.
Great pass there by Ben Carter. I think he didn't know he was going to shake his man like that. He had the little floater he could have went to right there, but Cody Bear going to get himself 2 free throws.
Not exactly. I don't know if you're ever expecting to lose somebody on a move.
Yeah.
But, yeah, he certainly lost Adams on that, a bit surprisingly.
Yeah, he broke him.
It's a good sign from Cody Bear at the free throw line. It's shooting percentage from there has dropped through the past few games. He was about 90% early on in the season. It's sitting about 83 right now, but
Which is still fantastic.
Absolutely. One of the better free throw shooters in the conference. And you're welcome, Cody Bear. And I apologize.
There we go. Jinxing again.
I should have waited until after the shot.
Yeah.
He gets a steal on the perimeter regardless. He's going to run the break himself. Contact up to the bucket. No call. Brown just got bopped in the nose. Good transition defense from the Red Devils to get back into play. Parker to Adams. Head fake. Gets Bear in the air, and Bear makes sure he doesn't get a shot up.
Adams, not, you know, really been effective from the field tonight, but he's been effective at getting to the line. I believe this is third or fourth trip at the line today. Red Devils really being aggressive and making them work for it.
Hey, we always talk about not wanting to give up easy baskets, and Cody Bear certainly, I wouldn't say without, like, it was within reason, the contact that he provided. I didn't think it was anything malicious. But
yeah, it wasn't nothing dirty.
Certainly wanted to make sure that layup was not getting up towards the basket very cleanly.
Like I said, you know, I can definitely tell this was emphasized in practice and through film to slow down Adams, not let him get comfortable. And if you have to be a little physical sometimes, I mean, that's free throws and fouls are part of basketball. Like you said, it was nothing dirty, and Adams only a 71% free throw shooter himself. As he proves me wrong and catches that one. Shows what I know.
Yeah, we get asked to analyze things, and then we're like, oh, yeah, these are the trends. You know, these are what every number is pointing towards, and then they do the opposite. You know, it's just, what can you do?
Like, why do I even have a stat sheet? It's pointless.
No, I'm not going to start. I'm just going to stop researching at this point. I'm just going to go into every game with a blank slate and just try to figure out, based on the game, what people do.
Just go with the flow. I say he's a 70% shooter. He knocks them both down. I'm done.
Principia back within single digits now. Blake Logsdon back onto the court and bringing it up. Carter, deep three up over Adams. That one rattles out. Good box outs underneath.
Carter feeling it. Not going to say a heat check, but.
He likes to expand the range.
I want to see what was cooking.
Cockburn loses Logsdon. Ball on the ground. Still scrapped for it. Bear got tied up there by Cockburn. Looks like Bear's bleeding from the elbow there.
Cody Bear, no stranger to fouls. You know, no love lost. Him and Adams shaking hands after it. Just all competitive basketball.
I don't know if it was Adams that drew blood on that. I think it was Cockburn that still had his arm pinned and maybe a nail scratch. I always hated that in basketball. Oh, it's always inadvertent, but those hurt the worst sometimes.
If we hoop and cut your nails, bro.
Brown to Persich to Logsdon. Logsdon in the pick and roll. Beautiful take by Blake Logsdon.
Oh my God, he gave me a Jalen Brunson impression like that. Had to hit defender on his back and was wide open.
So being pass first can do to free sometimes. You expect to throw to the reigning Slack player of the year and just do it yourself. Get you two free ones.
Blake Logsdon can get buckets.
To the bucket, left-handed take, no good. Carter, about an even break. Logsdon, Persich, another head fake, gets to a spot there. Adams was not very aggressive player. You can tell he's biting on a lot of these fakes.
Yeah.
Pass one off of the leg of Ben Carter.
That's a good and a bad thing about, you know, aggressive players. We were talking about it earlier in the women's game with Lainey Moore. You know, it can be a detriment and it can be a positive. You're so aggressive sometimes. You're jumping at everything, or you're fouling unintentionally, or you're moving too fast. Just got to tame it and bring it all in.
11:46 left in the second half. Adams, nice take with the left. Can't finish. Bear goes to the ground. Floater up with the right hand that time goes in.
I think Adams got bailed out that Cody Bear ended up on the ground after the miss.
And demonstrating the ability to use either hand on that. Missed with the left, went with the right.
Like we said, I don't even know what hand he is. He shoots free throws left hand but drives with his right.
Looks like the theory with LeBron being left-handed. Yeah. He just decided to shoot with his right. Bear fadeaway.
Yeah, I could tell that wasn't going to get there.
Adams has to kick out Miles. Jonah Loft onto the floor. Miles right by him to the glass. Loft picks up a rebound. Brown in transition, three-pointer up from him, too strong. Goes to the floor. Here's Miles, about 2-on-2. Miles will just reset.
Smart play.
Bird, right by Loft, around Bear.
Loft, not known as a extremely lateral quick defender. Once he bit on the fake, kind of got lost in the sauce.
A really great finish around Cody Bear. Again, a top five shot blocker in the SLIAC this season. Levin on the shot clock. Red Devils taking their time. Here's Blake Logsdon trying to get around Bird. Kicked it off his own foot. Never a fun feeling dribbling it off of your own foot.
Yeah.
I was due for one of those at least once every game.
I wasn't, because I wasn't dribbling.
Starting to notice we had very different roles on our teams.
Yeah, I was
outside of the not scoring expectation.
Yeah. It's more of the foul, intimidate the other team type of guy.
Good scoop there. Isaiah Parker, I mean, I think outside of Jaquan Adams, now the only other guy in double figures.
Yep.
And I don't think Parker came into this game averaging double digits.
Yeah. Principia starting to get it together.
Rika taking a timeout to try to quell some momentum. It's a 42-37 lead for the Red Devils. 9:46 remaining on ECTV.
That's what the world's been saying for centuries. But now we've got something to say. Save it.
It's time to save ourselves
by saving our money. Until we're no longer 80% more likely than men to live in poverty in retirement.
Save it. The falsehoods, the feelings of fault.
Then, the funds. Learn how to save for your retirement at wesaysaveit.org.
5-point lead for the Red Devils here at home. Going to pick up their fifth win of the season. Spencer Davis, Kareem Burnett with you. Kareem talking about Isaiah Parker putting up some numbers we're not expected.
Yeah, only averages about 5 points on the season. He's doubled that already in this game, up to 10. As you mentioned, him and Jaquan Adams being the only double-digit scorers. And, you know, Principia going on a little run of their own. They've cut the 10-point lead down in half. Trying to, you know, make it a ball game. We know, as you said, they're about seventh in the SLIAC, with the SLIAC leading scorer. They're not going to go down without a fight.
Cody Bear coming back onto the floor with a wrap, and they get a travel there on Pee Wee Brown. Parker, again, defensively as well.
Yeah, I think Parker anticipated that Euro step, swallowed up all the space, and Pee Wee Brown tried to take another step, but he only allowed two.
Parker doubled off of the screen. Brown wanted that. And that ball is deflected out of bounds. 13 on the shot clock.
Lee Brown didn't really see what happened. He got a little limp.
We saw him tweak it earlier. Him and Jaquan Adams kind of collided. And Adams slipped earlier on in the first half. 7 on the shot clock. 3-pointer up. No good. Logsdon and Adams boxing each other out. Both these teams come into this game averaging over 70 points per game. Right now, it's certainly not on pace to reach that.
This one's a betting, man.
We'll be lucky to hit 60 on either of these teams. Three-pointer up from Bird. Bear goes for it, ends up with it. It's Brown. Brown, Euro steps around Parker. A tough one to read.
Yeah, I couldn't really tell what they were going to do with that one. You know, Brown and Parker having a little back and forth.
We know Pee Wee Brown doesn't mind the little chat throughout the game. Miles slips a pass. Alford dribbled it off of his own foot.
Great defense there by Cody Bear.
It's a 7-point game in favor of the home Red Devils. 8:18 left in the second half. Carter to Brown. It's Adams collecting the rebound. Kareem, on that last shot, it's kind of the shot that I don't like too much as a Jason Tatum fan. The one that's 1 foot inside the three-point line.
Long twos. Just take one step back, go for the extra point.
Persich trying to get to the bucket, blocked there by Miles. Parker stepped on the line as he went to save it. You know, we've seen him, the Red Devils specifically, throw the ball off of the Principia players. I haven't seen a Principia player throw it off of their own guy before.
Yeah, I haven't seen that today, but.
About happened.
Yeah.
Would have happened if he hadn't been on the line originally. Both the Logsdon brothers out there. Nice slip from Ben Carter.
Ben Carter up to 12 points today. No, 14 points, I think.
Yeah, I think he's right around the leading scorer. I think Pee-wee Brown a little bit higher, but him off the floor. And again, no live stats for the guys up here. Doing our best.
I promise we're trying.
Adams, straight to the bucket. Made a sound as he went up. Refs did not care. Persich on the break. Corner three-pointer from Logsdon. Yes! Back up 12, courtesy of Dylan Logsdon.
Dylan Logsdon with a great momentum bucket. Now, see, that is a bucket I will also define as clutch. As Ben Carter almost comes up with the steal. Right as Principia was starting to make their run, a clutch three right there, put it back up to 12.
Full timeout taken by Principia. Eureka stretching the lead out to 12. Should be a fun finish upcoming. 7 minutes even remaining in the second half right here on ECTV.
Being a part of the different activities and organizations that I've been a part of, I'm actually able to see myself where I'm like, hey, I actually can make a change. I'm one person that can make a difference.
Division III has helped me to develop teamwork skills, critical thinking skills, time management skills.
It's not just about basketball or it's not just about school. It's about developing yourself as a person altogether.
Earlier on in the game with both the Logsdon brothers and Jalen Johnson being really, really good at drawing charges, and the fact that was brought to our attention, both their fathers, coaches.
And it all makes sense right there. Coaches, they love the small details like charges, something that isn't appreciated in the game of basketball enough. And we can see it from the Logsdon brothers and Jalen Johnson. Their dads being coaches really emphasize, hey, if you can get in there and just get in position and not move, that's a free turnover for us.
I'm sure watching basketball with a coach as well all the time, whether or not he's being a coach to you or just being able to pick up on these little things that they're talking about, it's significantly benefited the Red Devils defense, especially in a game like today where, again, it's going to be interesting to see if either team cracks 60 points.
Yeah, coach dads, they generate smart players.
And they get a blocking foul on Dylan Logsdon on there right after we were praising him for their charges.
Yeah.
Honestly, probably would have been better suited to stay on his feet because I think that was a call because he felt like there wasn't that much contact.
Yeah, and the shot clock was winding out, so, you know, could have just let it go.
And ends up resetting to 20. Jaquan Adams, a lot of steam towards the bucket, can't finish with the right.
Oh, the lid has been on the rim for Jaquan Adams this game. Not really his best shooting night. Principia as a whole hasn't been shooting it great.
Good backdoor cut from Logsdon, can't finish, Bird rebounds.
I think he should have finished with the left on that time.
6:15 left in the second half. It's Parker trying to get around Bear. Great finish.
Parker extremely energized and animated in this game, trying to get his team going.
This is one of those moments. It seems like a big energy play from the Red Devils.
Yeah.
Could really get the crowd going and put this game close to on ice. Starting to put it on chill, at least.
Yeah.
Bear down low, doubled, finds Logsdon. To Persich all the way into the corner for Dylan. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Bear, four, Bear. Quadruple team throws it up and he gets fouled right before the shot clock expires.
Man, he was scraping and scratching for that one.
Cody Bear, 7 points from him tonight and probably one of the quietest games we'll see from him all year.
Yeah, only 7 points, but this has been a commanding lead for the Red Devils. With no Cody Bear offensively, He gets up to 8 now.
Having a guy like Ben Carter put in 14 for you, Pee-wee Brown in double digits as well. You know, that's what makes your team dangerous, is having guys that can score even when your best players aren't putting up their huge numbers.
And we can win games like this where Pee-wee Brown and Cody Bear don't have to get 20, 25 plus a night or 39, as we've seen with Pee-wee Brown against Greenville. You know, really helps the team confidence as a whole.
Getting multiple buckets from guys on your bench is massive, especially getting later into the season. Adams, great finish.
And as the team chemistry, you know, when you, one of your role players gets a bucket or hits a big-time three and everybody's cheering for him, you know, it brings the team together.
It's a 10-point lead for the Red Devils. You can tell their offensive set starting to slow down a little bit, trying to burn a little bit of clock. Carter from three. Chalk! 13-point lead.
Ben Carter doing his best Klay Thompson impression. He's up to 3 of 4 threes on the day. He's letting it ride.
Under 5 to go. Miles poked loose. Both the Logsdon brothers there, and it's off of Miles. Sam DeJesus onto the court for the Red Devils, as well as Jordan Williams.
Yeah, I haven't seen much DeJesus in this game, especially since early in the first half, but you know the type of player he is. He comes in, high energy, high rebound, high motor guy.
And a travel called. An extra step before the pass, I guess?
I'm not really sure at all on that play. What do I know?
I think it was just one of those you look away because you're expecting to see where the pass is going. You don't even think about something like that. Good defense from Carter. Eureka's defense just swarming today. Charge drawn there from Dylan Logsdon.
That's another charge drawn from a Logsdon. That's Dylan Logsdon's second charge drawn today. I think that's his fourth charge attempt. I see him kind of rubbing his backside a little bit, you know. Those, taking all those charge calls can be kind of tedious on the body.
I'm going to have to start, like, logging, like, shot attempts with charge attempts. Shooting 50% on his charge attempts today.
I wonder, would that be good or...
Yeah, I would say you want a higher percentage. Yeah. Like, you want 100%. If you're trying to get a charge, you want to get it.
I wonder if that stat is out there, how good 50% on charge attempts is.
For Marcus Smart, with his reputation, that would be really good.
It would. Marcus Smart, any opportunity to take a charge, he finds it.
Blake Logsdon struggling to find anybody. DeJesus to Brown. Working it around. Carter, too much time at the line. 20 points from Ben Carter.
Ben Carter.
Woo. Yeah, you weren't here for the 5-for-5 from three game, but Ben Carter with 4 threes tonight. His team up 16. Bird, nice finish.
If I was here for that game, I might have lost my mind. Blake Logsdon initiating the offense.
Carter. About travel. Ref wanted to call it. DeJesus! Everybody getting in on the scoring action.
They're really shooting these guys out of the building from deep. I think we're up to like 6 or 7 threes as a team made today.
Jump hook way off from Adams.
Adams not able to get anything going. Even Pee-wee Brown, he letting them know he has that on lock. Even one-on-one with no help side defenders.
These two teams will see each other again later on in the season. You have to imagine the Principia is going to want some revenge for what's turned into somewhat of a beatdown.
Anticipating a big play here.
6 on the shot clock. Logsdon. Going to go around Miles, flips it up, and he's fouled.
The last time we seen these guys face up was last year. It was a nail-biter OT win. Quan Adams had 19 in that game. You know, he's up to 14 points, but it's really, really been a tough 14. A lot of it has been at the free throw line. He's been seeing one-on-ones. He's been seeing doubles. He's been seeing zones. They really have made it hard for him as an offensive player tonight.
Yeah, you can tell he's not getting the looks he usually wants. Yeah. And, I mean, 70% from the free throw line is certainly acceptable as a forward. You want a guy shooting about 70%. But, again, you're hoping that a lot more of these bunnies that he's getting closer to the hoop, they're just not going down. Maybe it's just he's going to the left, and that didn't work, so he went to the right, and that worked. And then the next time down, he tried the right, and that one didn't work. And it's just it's good to have both hands, but if neither of them are working as you need them to, it's probably a bit frustrating.
Yeah, when the team is sending multiple different defensive options, you're starting to get confused because, like you said, I'm going to go to the right hand. It's not working. And I try to go to my left, but they switched the defensive scheme.
Tough take from Bird. Can't finish.
I would like to know what Bird vertical is. He gets so high on these jump shots and floaters.
Blake logs into Dillon. Slips a pass to DeJesus, who slips.
Able to recover that steal.
Crowd wanted to travel. I don't know what the reasoning was for not giving one out, I guess.
Maybe he failed before he grabbed the ball.
I think that was what it was. Brown to the bucket. Tough take. Can't finish. Adams, 2-on-3, trying to outrun the Red Devils. Great find. DeJesus forcing a miss. Ball ricocheting around on the baseline. Adams trapped by the Red Devils and teammate. Cockburn from three. No.
He didn't even jump.
DeJesus, and they'll get him for a foul as he's trying to guard Alford.
Yeah, DeJesus with that great recovery defense. He fouled on this play, but the play before that was excellent, excellent defense by DeJesus.
And Alford, I just scored his first points tonight. Again, comes into this 13.7 points per game. Just, I don't know if he just didn't match up well with the Red Devil defense or what, but yeah, really great performance. I mean, shutting down a lot of the scoring that this team is supposed to offer.
Yeah, I gave you guys the stats in the first half. I didn't even include Alpha the third in that. He's their second leading scorer, and he has 0 points. And really been a rough night for Principia.
Jesus to Dillon Logsdon. Sizing up Williams, kicks out Blake. Floater with the left short. Solace with a rebound.
Less than a minute and a half to play. Should be a much needed win for the Red Devils here.
Miles, good slip pass. Alford getting his.
Great pass there by Miles.
Concibia taking a timeout to sub. Point game for the Red Devils, a minute 14 remaining. Again, like Kareem said, this is a massive win going forward for the Red Devils. Again, they were 1-8 in their last nine.
Yeah, this is a much, much needed win, especially after the nail-biter loss to Greenville a few days ago. They really needed this one.
That's been kind of the unfortunate part for the Red Devils, is a lot of these games they're losing are extremely close in the conference, but it also... it bodes well. You're going to get, well, like, this is the rematch part of the schedule. I think this is the last unique team we haven't played yet. And now it's starting to go to the rematches. We get Webster on Wednesday. That'll be a huge matchup. And shot clock expired. But again, with 43 seconds left, not too much to be concerned about, barring a Tracy McGrady music hit.
Well, you know, we always say that one day we're going to get one of those T-Mac-like performances. Hopefully it will be our guys doing the T-Mac-ing.
True that. Ben Carter getting a nice ovation coming off the floor. 20 points from him tonight. Tough take there from Williams. We have the next four games for the Red Devils. Go Webster on the road, at home against Spalding, and then at home against Lyon and the Mississippi University for Women. And those are some pretty large games looming. Again, Lyon, I believe, at the top of the conference standings. Webster usually up there as well. And that means Greenville's looming late in the season as well. You know these guys would like another shot at them.
You're definitely going to want another shot at those guys.
Red Devils with both Logsdon brothers. Jonah Loft with the ball now. Ray Banzamuna and Sam DeJesus. Here's Dylan Logsdon, lays it up and in. Thought he was about to turn that upside down.
Oh, man, if he would have dunked on him, this crowd would have went crazy.
Miles forced to kick out. Williams resets the feet and left short. That might just be the last statistic we see of the night. And it looks like it will be 64-49. Red Devils taking this one at home. And Kareem, just a really great team effort today.
Great, great team effort. We had so many guys show up tonight. Ben Carter, he's going to be the main guy. 20 points tonight. I think he made four threes. I could be wrong. It was four or threes. But the thing that really stood out the most, our defense from all five guys. We've seen not only did we lock down Jaquan Adams today, but as a whole, they just locked down Principia today. Defense won this game. Hadn't been Carter.
Yeah, this is the lowest opponent output that we've seen this season. Monmouth only able to put up 56 in the home win that the Red Devils had. And then in conference play, 64 points put up by Fontbon. But again, holding a team to under 50 points through 40 minutes of play is sensational.
Holding the team to 50 points and they have a trio that averages 50 points by themselves is super, super impressive when you put the contacts in.
Fantastic game played there by the Red Devils. The next time out, they'll be facing Webster. Again, women and men, the games will tip off 5:30 and 7:30 again at Webster. It'll be on WEUR, so look forward to seeing you there. Tip-off times 5:30, 7:30. Can't wait to bring that one to you. On behalf of our entire crew, my broadcast partner, Kareem Burnett, this is Spencer Davis. Thank you for joining us. Have a great evening.